Hi dear students, good morning and welcome to the new episode of English class. In the previous class, we discussed the first part of our third lesson, that is the cat seller and the monkey. What is the title of our third lesson? The cat seller and the monkey is the title of our third lesson. Okay, I'll read the first part and then I'll explain the summary once again. Hope all of you read the first part and you will be very interested. You will be very familiar with all the words and you are very interested to read and know what is happened in the next part. Okay. Gopal was a poor man. He had no means of earning money. Gopal was a poor man. He had no means of earning money. So he decided to sell calves. Gopal was a poor man. He had no means of earning money. For his living. So he decided, he planned to sell calves. He sold them by walking from one place to another. That means village to village. His calves used to be tied in a bundle which he carried on his head. It was a hot summer afternoon. He had walked a long distance from the village. He was tired. He began to feel sleepy. Gopal began to feel sleepy. He passed through a forest and saw a large banyan tree. The shade was inviting. He put his bundle down and soon fell asleep. Soon Gopal fell asleep. On the tree lived a big family of monkeys. A naughty little baby monkey silently went and took out a calf from the bundle. He put it on and climbed up the tree. The monkeys, having the habit of imitating, followed him, and all the calves were on the head of the monkeys. When Gopal woke up, he found that there were no calves. He was puzzled. Then he looked up and understood what had happened. He tried to shoo the monkeys, but nothing happened. He shouted at them, but they shouted back. Then he remembered that monkeys imitate all actions. So he threw his cap on the ground and the monkeys too did the same. He quickly gathered his caps and proceeded on his way. That was the first part. Okay, I'll say the summary. Who was Gopal? Gopal was a poor man. And what did he do to earn his living? He decided to sell caps to earn his living. How did he sell the caps? He collected the caps and tied the caps in a bundle that he carried on his head from village to village. One day, it was a summer afternoon, and Gopal became very tired after traveling for a long distance. After walking for a long distance, Gopal became very tired. So he decided to, he wanted some rest. He was in a forest and there he saw a big banyan tree. The tree was very big and it was full of leaves and the shade was very inviting. The tree shade was very inviting. So he decided to take rest for some day. He put his bundle of caps on the ground and suddenly he sat there for a while. He lay asleep and lied there and then he fell asleep for a long time. While he was sleeping, what happened? There were so many monkeys, a big family of monkeys lived in that banyan tree, the same banyan tree. And while Gopal was sleeping, a little baby monkey came there and silently went and took out a calf from the bundle. And the baby monkey put on the calf on his head and he climbed up the tree. Monkeys are in the habit of imitating whatever they are seeing. So all the monkeys came down on seeing the baby monkey and they all untied the bundle and took out all the caps. Now all the caps were on the heads of the monkeys. After a long time's sleep, Gopal woke up from his sleep and then he was surprised that there was no cap in the bundle. He was confused. He was puzzled. P-U-Z-Z-L-E-D. Puzzled means confused. He became confused and he looked everywhere. Then he looked up and saw the monkeys on the tree. They were wearing the caps. Then he understood what happened. And then he tried to shoo the monkeys away. Whenever there is some birds or animals, we shoo them and we shoo them away. But there was no result. Whenever Gopal tried to shoo the monkeys away, there was no result. And Gopal, what did Gopal do? Gopal shouted at the monkeys. Then the monkeys shouted back. Then Gopal remembered that monkeys are in the habit of imitating things. He was a clever man. Gopal was a clever man, and he took out his cap and put it on the ground. Throw it on the ground. All the monkeys took out their caps and throw it on the ground. Okay. Then what happened? Gopal gathered. Gathered means collected. G-A-T-H-E-R-E-D. Gathered means collected. Gopal collected all the caps from the ground and he tied it in the bundle and then he started his journey. Okay, he continued his journey. I'll read that portion once again. You please listen. Gopal was a poor man. He had no means of earning money. So he decided to sell caps. He sold them by walking from village to village. His caps used to be tied in a bundle which he carried on his head. It was a hot afternoon, hot summer afternoon. He had walked a long distance from the village. He was tired. He began to feel sleepy. He passed through a forest and saw a large banyan tree. The shade was inviting. He put his bundle down and soon fell asleep. On the tree lived a big family of monkeys. A naughty little baby monkey silently went and took out a cap from the bundle. He put it on and climbed up the tree. The monkeys, having the habit of imitating, followed him, and all the caps were on the heads of the monkeys. When Gopal woke up, he found that there were no caps. He was puzzled. Then he looked up and understood what had happened. He tried to shoo away the monkeys, but nothing happened. He shouted at them, but they shouted back. Then he remembered that monkeys imitate all actions, so he threw his cap on the ground and the monkeys too did the same. He quickly means suddenly. He suddenly gathered his caps and proceeded, means continued. Proceeded on his way. Proceeded. P-R-O-C-E-E-D-E-D. Proceeded. Okay. Let us have a look at the second part. Keshav, the grandson of Gopal, followed his grandfather's profession. Who was Keshav? Spelling K-E-S-H-A-V. K-E-S-H-A-V. Keshav is the grandson. G-R-A-N-D-S-O-N. Grandson. Grandmother. Who is grandmother? The mother of our parents are called the grandmothers. The father of parents are called grandfathers. And who is a grandson and a granddaughter? The daughter of our children are called the daughter of our son or daughter is called a granddaughter, and the daughter of a man's or the son of a man's son or daughter is called a grandson. Okay, grandson, granddaughter, grandmother and grandfather. Okay, grandparents and grandchildren. Okay, then here, who is the grandson of Gopal? Keshav is the grandson of Gopal. Keshav is the grandson of Gopal and he followed his grandfather's profession. Profession means work. What was the profession of Gopal? Gopal was a cap seller. Gopal was a cap seller. And Keshav, the grandson of Gopal, followed, spelling F-O-L-L-O-W-E-D. Followed. F-O-L-L-O-W-E-D. Gopal was the grandfather and Keshav was the grandson of Gopal. Keshav also followed. That means he is also doing the same job. He followed the profession. Job, profession, work, P-R-O-F-E-S-S-I-O-N. Profession. Listen to the spelling. P-R-O-F-E-S-S-I-O-N. Profession. Gopal was the grandfather of Keshav, and Keshav, the grandson of Gopal, is doing the same job of his grandfather. He is also a cab seller. Okay, he is following the profession of profession means job. PROFESSION, profession. The profession of his grandfather Gopal. Okay, I'll read the paragraph once again. You please listen, page number 28. Keshav, the grandson of Gopal, followed his grandfather's profession. He too sold cabs from the village to village. He is also doing the same profession. That means he too sold, S-O-L-D, sold the past tense of sell, S-O-L-D. He is also selling cabs from one village to the other. He is also walking by foot from one village to the other. Keshav, the grandson of Gopal, followed his grandfather's profession. He too sold cabs from village to village. He was a happy-go-lucky person and whistled as he went along his way. He is not a middle-aged man like Gopal or an old man like Gopal. He is a happy-go-lucky person. That means he is a young boy. He is a young man. He is a young man and he is a happy-go-lucky person. That means he is not worried about his household responsibilities. He is not worried about making money. He is not worried about anything in the world. He is a happy-go-lucky man. He is simply a man. He whistled as he went along his way. He whistled. That means people are in the habit of singing silently or whistling while they are doing jobs. He whistled. W-H-I-S-T-L-E-D. Whistled. Listen to the spelling. W-H-I-S-T-L-E-D. Whistled. The J is silent there. This word is pronounced as whistled. W-H-I-S-T-L-E-D. Whistled. Do you know how to whistle? How many of you can whistle? This is whistling. This is whistling. How do you whistle? Can you make a whistle? This is whistling. And here our Keshav is in the habit of whistling. He is a happy-go-lucky person. How do Keshav is described here? Keshav is a happy-go-lucky person. H-A-P-P-Y. Happy-go. It's a usage. Happy-go-lucky person. Happy-go-lucky person. U-C-K-Y. Happy-go-lucky man. That means he is not bothered about or he is not worried about anything that is happening around him. He is a happy-go-lucky man. And he whistled as he went along his way. As he is going or as he is traveling, as he is walking through the village, he is whistling. He is whistling. W-H-I-S-T-L-E-D. Whistled. W-H-I-S-T-L-E-D. Whistled. You please listen to that two paragraphs. Keshav, the grandson of Gopal, followed his grandfather's profession. He too sold cabs from village to village. He was a happy-go-lucky person and whistled as he went along his way. Listen to the next paragraph. One day, during summers, he was crossing the same jungle as his grandfather. That means long ago his grandfather Gopal crossed the forest. Forest means jungle. J-U-N-G-L-E. Jungle. What is the meaning of jungle? Forest. J-U-N-G-L-E. Jungle means forest. J-U-N-G-L-E. Jungle meaning forest. As he was traveling through this same jungle where his grandfather traveled. Okay. One day during summers, he was crossing, C-R-O-S-S-I-N-G. He was crossing means he was traveling through. C-R-O-S-S-I-N-G. Crossing means traveling through. He was crossing the same jungle as his grandfather. He was traveling through the same jungle and he reached near the same banyan tree. Tired of walking, he thought of taking some rest. As he is walking a long distance through the forest carrying the bundle of cabs, what did he do? He decided to take rest. Oh, Keshav decided to take rest for some day. Tired of walking, Keshav decided to take rest for some day. Tired of walking, what did Keshav decide? Tired of walking, Keshav decided to take rest for some day. Tired of walking, he thought of taking some rest. He saw a huge banyan tree, that same tree. Coincidentally, it was the same tree under which his grandfather had taken rest many years ago. Many years ago, his grandfather took rest under a big banyan tree, and after 20 or 30 years, here our Keshav decided to take rest under the same tree, same banyan tree. Coincidentally, it is not happened decidedly, but coincidentally, it is a new word for you. Coincidentally, coincidentally. Coincidentally, coincidentally, it happened unknowingly. Without consciousness, they are making the. He is not consciously taking rest under the same tree, but coincidentally, unconsciously, he came to the same tree where his grandfather took rest before many years. Before many years, his grandfather took rest under the same banyan tree, and here now after duration of long years, a few years, Keshav came to the same tree for taking rest. Keshav came under the same banyan tree to take rest. Okay. Coincidentally, it was the same tree under which his grandfather had taken rest many years ago. He put down his bundle and went to sleep. Like his grandfather, Keshav put his bundle of calves under the tree and began to sleep. Look at that paragraph. There were many tough words in the paragraph. You please listen. Page number 29. One day during summers, he was crossing the same jungle as his grandfather. Tired of walking, he thought of taking some rest. He saw a huge banyan tree. Coincidentally, it was the same tree under which his grandfather had taken rest many years ago. He put down his bundle and went to sleep. What did Keshav do? Keshav put down his bundle of caps and went to sleep. B-U-N-D-L-E. Bundle means kit. Bundle. B-U-N-D-L-E. Bundle. Let us have a look at the tough words of these paragraphs. Please listen. K-A-V-S-H-A-V. You study the spelling of tough words. These words were there in your question answers. Okay. These words were there in your question answers, and you study when the video come to you. Keshav. K-A-V-S-H-A-V. Who is Keshav? Keshav is the grandson of Gopal, the cab seller. Then grandson, G-R-A-N-D-S-O-N. Grandson. Then followed. Next word is followed. F-O-L-L-O-W-E-D. Followed. F-O-L-L-O-W-E-D. Followed. Next profession. P-R-O-F-E-S-S-I-O-N. Profession. How do we pronounce this word? Profession. P-R-O-F-E-S-S-I-O-N. Profession. Next word is sold. S-O-L-D. The past tense of sell. S-O-L-D. Sold. Next word, whistled. W-H-I-S-T-L-E-D. Whistled. W-H-I-S-T-L-E-D. Whistled. W-H-I-S-T-L-E-D. Whistled. Next word, jungle. J-U-N-G-L-E. Jungle. J-U-N-G-L-E. Jungle. Next word, crossing. C-R-O-S-S-I-N-G. Crossing. C-R-O-S-S-I-N-G. Crossing. Next word, coincidentally. Coincidentally, I-N-C-I-D-E-N-T-L-Y. Coincidentally. 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 Okay. Next word is bundle. 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 Okay. What kind of a man is Keshav? Keshav is a happy go lucky man. Keshav is a happy go lucky man. Okay. I read the three paragraphs once again. You please listen. Keshav, the grandson of Gopal, followed his grandfather's profession. He too sold calves from village to village. He was a happy-go-lucky person and whistled as he went along his way. One day, during summers, he was crossing the same jungle as his grandfather. Tired of walking, he thought of taking some rest. He saw a huge banyan tree. Coincidentally, it was the same tree under which his grandfather had taken rest many years ago. He put down his bundle and went to sleep. Once again, Keshav, grandson, followed profession, salt, whistle, jingle, crossing, coincidentally, bundle. Okay, I hope all of you understood these words. I am going to rub it. Next paragraph. It is said that history repeats itself. Once again, the monkeys came and took away all his caps. It is said that history is the record of past events. That means something happened in the past with Gopal. And here, the same thing happened to Keshav. History repeats. History is spelling H-I-S-T-O-R-Y. It is not history, it is history. H-I-S-T-O-R-Y. History repeats. R-E-P-E-A-T-S. R-E-P-E-A-T-S. Repeats means again, once again. Happened once again. Repeats. History repeats means the things happened to his grandfather happened here. It is happening here for the second time. It is happening here for the second time. It is said that history repeats itself. Once again, the monkeys came and took away all his calves. What happened to Gopal? When Gopal took rest under this huge banyan tree, under this big banyan tree, what happened? Some monkeys came there and took all his calves and they returned to the tree. Like that, while Keshav is taking rest under this tree after many years, what happened? History repeats. That means all the monkeys came down and took away his calves. All the calves were taken away by the monkeys and now the monkeys were wearing the calves. All the monkeys were having the cap on their head and they were sitting on the branches of the banyan tree. They were sitting on the branches of the banyan tree. It is said that history repeats itself. Once again, the monkeys came and took away all his caps. Keshav woke up and realized what had happened. After Keshav woke up from his sleep, woke up means he waked up. Woke up. W-O-K-E-U-P. Woke up. After Gopal, Keshav woke up, he realized what had happened. He understood. H-A-P-P-E-N-E-D happened, whatever happened. After something, Gopal's, Keshav's caps were not there in the bundle. All the caps were taken away by the monkeys. All the caps were taken away by the monkeys. Now all the monkeys are having a cap on their head and they were taking rest on the tree. Okay, while Keshav was sleeping, all these things happened. When Keshav woke up from his sleep, he found that there were no caps in the bundle and when he looked up, he saw the monkeys with the caps. Then he realized, means he understood. Then he understood what had happened to here the calves. Then Keshav understood what had happened to his calves. Keshav woke up and realized what had happened. He threw a stick at the monkeys. They plucked and threw leaves at him. What did Keshav do? Keshav is not aware of what had happened to his grandfather Gopal. Keshav took a stick and threw to them. Keshav threw a stick at the monkeys. Threw, the past tense of throw. Keshav took a stick from the ground and he threw the stick on the monkeys. Then what happened? Monkeys plucked leaves from the tree and they throw it on Keshav. He threw stick at the monkeys. They plucked and threw leaves. They plucked. Plucked means break. Plucked. P-L-U-C-K-E-D. Plucked. P-L-U. P-L-U-C-K-E-D. Plucked. Keshav threw a stick on the monkeys. And for imitating that, what did the monkeys do? The monkeys plucked leaves from the banyan tree and threw on Keshav. They threw the leaves on Keshav. Okay, Keshav woke up and realized what had happened. He threw a stick at the monkeys. They plucked and threw leaves at him. He remembered what his grandfather had told him when he was small. At that time, this incident happened to Gopal. Keshav was a young child, little baby. And he remembered, R-E-M-E-M-B-E-R-E-D, remembered, R-E-M-E-M-B-E-R-E-D, he remembered, Keshav remembered what Gopal told about the incident. At that time, while he saw the monkeys plucking leaves from the banyan tree and throwing it on Keshav, Keshav remembered what his grandfather told about that incident. What his grandfather told about that incident. And then he understood that. He remembered what his grandfather had told him about the incident when he was small. He took off his cap and threw it on the ground. What did Keshav do? Keshav remembered about that incident and he took out his cap. Took out means remove. He removed his cap and threw it on the ground. Keshav also, like his grandfather, removed his cap, took out the cap in his hand. He removed his cap and threw it on the ground. But the monkeys only grinned. Grinned means a kind of smiling. The monkeys only grinned. G-R-I-N-N-E-D. The monkeys only G-R-I-N-N-E-D. Grinned. The monkeys only grinned at him. That means mocked at him. But the monkeys only grinned. An old monkey said, Keshav, even our grandfather had told us the same story. Now many years passed away. And many years passed. And now the monkeys living in that tree were the grandson of their grandfathers. Okay. They were also grandson. Now Keshav is... At that time Keshav was very young. Like that, at that time these monkeys were very young. Like that, Keshav threw away his cap, remove his cap and throw it on the ground. Then the monkeys grinned at him. G-R-I-N-N-E-D. Grinned. What is the meaning of grinned? Smiling. As mocking. M-O-C-K-I-N-G. Mocking means kaliyakichirikkuka. Mocking. And here the monkeys mocked at Keshav. And one of the old monkeys said that, Keshav, even our grandfather has told us the same story. Our grandfather told us how your grandfather cheated them. How your grandfather took out all the caps. So we are aware of that. We did not imitate your action. We did not imitate your action by taking our caps and throw it to the ground. Okay, then who is cleverer than Keshav? Who is the cleverer one? Monkeys are the cleverer one. Monkeys are the cleverer one. Okay, I will read today's question once again. You please listen. Keshav, the grandson of Gopal, followed his grandfather's profession. He too sold calves from village to village. He was a happy-go-lucky person and whistled as he went along his way. He is in the habit of making whistles. One day during summers, he was crossing the same jungle as his grandfather. Tired of walking, he thought of taking rest. Taking some rest. He saw a huge banyan tree. Coincidentally, it was the same tree under which his grandfather had taken rest many years ago. He put down his bundle and went to sleep. It is said that history repeats itself. Once again, the monkeys came and took away all his caps. Keshav woke up and realized what had happened. He threw a stick at the monkeys. They plucked and threw leaves at him. He remembered what his grandfather had told him when he was small. He took off his cap and threw it on the ground. But the monkeys only grinned at him. An old monkey said, "Keshav, even our grandfather had told us the same story. Even our grandfather. Now you remember what your grandfather had told you. We also remembered what our grandfather had told us. So we didn't remove our caps and throw it as we did." Okay, this is the story. Is it interesting? Yes. Yes, I also found that this story is very interesting. I'll read from the very beginning. You take page number 27 and listen to your text. Gopal was a poor man. He had no means of earning money. So he decided to sell caps. He sold them by walking from village to village. His caps used to be tied in a bundle which he carried on his head. It was a hot summer afternoon. He had walked a long distance from the village. He was tired. He began to feel sleepy. He passed through a forest and saw a large banyan tree. The shade was inviting. He put his bundle down and soon fell asleep. On the tree lived a big family of monkeys. A naughty little baby monkey silently went and took out a calf from the bundle. He put it on and climbed up the tree. The monkeys, having the habit of imitating, followed him, and all the calves were on the heads of the monkeys. When Gopal woke up, he found that there were no calves. He was puzzled. Then he looked up and understood what had happened. He tried to shoo the monkeys, but nothing happened. He shouted at them. They shouted back. Then he remembered that monkeys imitate all actions. So he threw his cap on the ground and the monkeys too did the same. He quickly gathered his caps and proceeded on his way. Keshav, the grandson of Gopal, followed his grandfather's profession. He too sold caps from village to village. He was a happy-go-lucky person and whistled as he went along his way. One day during summers, he was crossing the same jungle as his grandfather. Tired of walking, he thought of taking some rest. He saw a huge banyan tree. Coincidentally, it was the same tree under which his grandfather had taken rest many years ago. He put down his bundle and went to sleep. It is said that history repeats itself. Once again, the monkeys came and took away all his caps. Keshav woke up and realized what had happened. He threw a stick at the monkeys. They plucked and threw leaves at him. He remembered what his grandfather had told him when he was small. He took off his cap and threw it on the ground. But the monkeys only grinned. An old monkey said, "Keshav, even our grandfather had told us the same story." Okay, I'll say the words from this second part. History, H-I-S-T-O-R-Y, history. Say with me, H-I-S-T-O-R-Y, history. Next word repeats, R-E-P-E-A-T-S, repeats, R-E-P-E-A-T-S, repeats. Next word, woke up, W-O-P-E-U-P, woke up, W-O-K-E, the past tense of wake up is woke up. Woke up. Next word, realized, R-E-A-L-I, is a Z-E-D, realized. R-E-A-L-I-Z-E-D, realized. Next word, happened. H-A-P-P-E-N-E-D, happened. Next word, through. T-H-R-E-W, through. The past tense of throw, through. T-H-R-E-W. Next word, plucked. P-L-U-C-K-E-D, plucked. Next word, remembered. R-E-M-E-M-B-E-R-E-D, remembered. R-E-M-E-M-B-E-R-E-D. Next word, grinned. G-R-I-N-N-E-D, grinned. Listen here. History repeats. Woke up, realized, happened, threw, plucked, remembered, grinned. Okay, once again, history repeats, woke up, realized, happened, threw, plucked, remembered, grinned. Is it clear? Let us have a look at some simple question and answers for this lesson. What did Gopal do for a living? First question. Listen here. What did? W-H-A-T. What did? D-I-D. What did Gopal, G-O-P-A-L. Gopal, do for a living. Do for a living. Do for a living. What did Gopal do for a living? Can you say the answer? What did Gopal do for a living? Gopal did cab selling. Did the job of a cab seller. Gopal decided to sell cabs for his living. Gopal decided, D-E-C-I-D-E-D, decided to sell cabs, to sell cabs for a living, for a living. Say the question and answer once again. What did Gopal do for a living? Gopal decided to sell cabs for a living. Gopal decided to sell cabs for a living. Gopal decided to sell cabs. Okay. Then, which is the next question? What made Gopal sleepy? What made Gopal sleepy? W-H-A-T. What made? M-A-D. Made Gopal, G-O-P-A-L, Gopal, sleepy, S-L-E-E-P-Y. What made Gopal sleepy? What is the answer? Walking of a long distance made Gopal sleepy. Walking a long distance. A long distance. In the hot summer afternoon, walking a long distance in a hot summer afternoon, made Gopal sleepy, made Gopal sleepy, S-L-E-E-P-Y, sleepy. Is it clear? What made Gopal sleepy? It's a question. You put a question mark at the end of every question. Okay. What a long distance in a hot summer afternoon. Walking, as he walked for a long distance, it's the main reason. And the next reason is it was a hot summer afternoon. It was not an ordinary day. It was a hot day and it was summer season. Walking for a long distance in a hot summer afternoon made Gopal sleepy. Made Gopal feel sleepy. Okay, then which is the next question? Listen to the next question. What trick? Third question we can skip. Fourth question. What trick did Gopal play to get his cap back? What trick did Gopal play? Third question. What trick? What trick? T-R-I-C-K. Trick. Did Gopal play? Did Gopal? G-O-P-A-L. Gopal play? G-O-P-A-L. Play. What trick did Gopal play to get his caps back? To get his caps. G-E-T. Get his caps back. This is the third question. This is the third question. What trick did Gopal play to get his cap back? What trick did Gopal play? Gopal removed his caps or took off his cap. Gopal threw his cap on the ground. Gopal answered. Gopal threw his cap on the ground. Cap on the ground. Comma, knowing that he knows that. Knowing K-N-O-W-I-N-G. Knowing that the monkeys will imitate. The monkeys will imitate. Knowing that the monkeys will imitate the same action, the same thing. Gopal threw his cap on the ground, knowing that the monkeys will imitate the same thing. Gopal knew very well that the monkeys will imitate whatever they see. Okay, knowing that Gopal threw his cap on the ground. Knowing that Gopal threw his cap on the ground. Asked did the monkeys and then Gopal get back his caps. Okay, please listen to the three question answers. I am reading once again. What did Gopal do for a living? What did Gopal do for a living? Gopal decided to sell caps for a living. Gopal decided to sell caps for a living. For earning money for his living, Gopal decided to sell caps. Gopal decided to sell caps. And what made Gopal sleepy? What thing made Gopal sleepy? Walking a long distance in a hot summer afternoon. Walking a long distance, he walked from very early morning to till the afternoon. And it was a hot summer day. And what kind of a day was it? It was a hot summer day. That made Gopal sleepy. Once again, what made Gopal sleepy? Answer is, walking a long distance in a hot summer afternoon made Gopal sleepy. Okay, then what trick did Gopal play to get his cap back? What trick did Gopal play? What trick did Gopal play to get his cap back? Okay, Gopal threw his cap on the ground. Gopal threw his cap on the ground, knowing that the monkeys will imitate the same thing. Knowing that the monkeys will imitate the same thing. Knowing that the monkeys will imitate the same thing. Next question. What type of a man is this? What type of a man was Keshav? was Keshav. Next question, what type of a man was Kesan was Keshav? Fourth question, what type of a person was P-E-R-S-O-N, person was Keshav, K-E-S-H-A-V. What type of a person was Keshav? What was his character? Keshav was a happy go lucky man. Keshav was a happy go lucky person. Keshav, K-E-S-H-A-V. Listen to the spelling. K-E-S-H-A-V. Keshav was a happy go lucky person. Happy go lucky person. Keshav was a happy go lucky person. Then next question. Did Keshav get back his caps? No, four questions are enough. Okay, I'll read the second, third and fourth question. Third and fourth questions once again. What trick did Gopal try to get his caps back? Gopal threw his cap on the ground, knowing that the monkeys will imitate the same thing. Once again, Gopal threw his caps on the ground, knowing that the monkeys will imitate the same thing. Fourth question. What type of a person was Keshav? Keshav was a happy go lucky person. Okay. It will be enough for today. And the most important thing is you should watch the video 2 or 3 times. And then you need not write down the question answers. The notes will come to you. You read the text carefully and try to find out the questions. Simple question answers. You can find more than 10 simple question and answers from this topic. Then it will be very easy for you to do comprehension passages. Okay. Wish you all the best for your studies. And see you in the next class. Thank you.